Good morning, church. Happy Sabbath. As we come into the house of the Lord, there's a interesting thing that we need to do. There's a moment of silence that the presence of the Lord is with us. But we need to listen to it. If we there it is. We want to invite His presence, His reverence here. And that's what we need to do. The hustle and the bustle of the world is outside. But right here is the presence of the Lord. Be reminded that. We're blessed and we're just preparing. They're just about to sing. And just let's ask the reverence of the Lord to be with us as well. Okay? Thank you.
Good morning, happy Sabbath. It is a beautiful sunny day outside after all that rain. I don't know if anyone made it home yesterday not getting wet because it came down. We're so grateful for you guys to come here to worship with us on this Sabbath, and we have very special King's Herald coming. So we're very grateful for this wonderful Sabbath, and it's ready to hear some beautiful music. But before we do all of that, if you could please join us. Right now, we're going to greet one another. At this time, we're changing up the program. If you could stand, if you like to, at your comfortability, to greet and say good morning to your fellow individuals next to you.
Thank you. presence with thanksgiving in your heart and give him praise, and give him praise. Come into his presence with thanksgiving in your heart, your voice is raised, your voice is raised.
Pray that your Holy Spirit will be with us, that the presence of Jesus will be felt, that all praise and honor will go to your name. Father, I pray that our hearts will be filled with gratitude anew, and that the blessings that you have for us will be received each into our lives. We may be drawn closer to our Savior, and better prepared for that wonderful day when he will come again. And so, Father, we give ourselves and we give this worship time to you in praise and thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, amen.
You may be seated.
It is a joy to welcome each of you this Sabbath morning to worship here at the Grand Prairie Seventh-day Adventist Church. Those of you who have joined us online, we welcome you. We're delighted that you have joined us as well for worship this morning. It's certainly my prayer that each of us will receive the blessings that God has for us, and I know there are many blessings that will be flowing this morning. You know, there's a expression that goes something like, it doesn't matter so much about what you know, but who you know. And I'm glad that Cherry Chong knows the Herald's, King's Herald's Quartet. Now, that doesn't mean that she doesn't know a lot. She knows a lot, but she also knows the quartet, and we're thankful for the contact that she's had, and we're just so thankful that they have accepted the invitation to come and join us in worship here at our church today. So I want to welcome the King's Herald's Quartet. We're delighted that you gentlemen are here, and I know that God will use you to bless our hearts. In the church bulletin, there is quite a repertoire of things that God has used these men to do. And I know that you, if you haven't yet, you will be reading it, and not during the service, though. Taking note of how God has used them in so many wonderful different ways. And we just feel blessed, privileged, thankful that they're here today. We welcome you and welcome everyone today as we have gathered for worship. I want to invite you to take your Bible, turn with me to our scripture selection at Psalm 28. Psalm 28, verses 6 and 7. The Psalm of David, blessed be the Lord, because he has heard the voice of my supplications. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusted in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song I will praise him. May God's blessing of his word touch our hearts, bring us closer to him, and help us to enjoy more fully what he has for us today.
Good morning. Happy Sabbath, church. The offering this morning is for the local church budget operation. So if keep your eyes on Vacation Bible School coming up in the next few weeks. The Vacation Bible School, the program today, these sort of programs and ministries are funded from the local budget. So this morning's offering will go to supply those needs. So we appreciate your kind giving and your prayers every week. Would the deacons come forward, please? Let's pray together here. Father, we want to thank you for the opportunity to come to worship and to come and to give a portion. It's just a portion of what you shared with us over the week. Lord, you've given us jobs. You've given us responsibilities. Thank you for providing the wisdom and power to do them. And now, Father, we give our gifts in gratitude to you for all these things. And ask that you will bless these funds, multiply them to finish the work in the cities of Grand Prairie and surrounding areas. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. And hello again. Want to join together for our family prayer this morning. If you can and feel comfortable doing so, let's please kneel and we'll pray together this morning. So thankful that we can come and worship in your church. Lord, we're thankful that you're a forgiving God and you will forgive us of our sins. We bring ourselves to you, Lord, and we kneel before you to ask for that forgiving grace and that mercy that comes from heaven. Father, this morning we want to ask a special blessing upon our quartet guests this morning as they sing. Now, I know for a long time I've grown up listening to the music of the King's Herald Quartet. Bless these men as they nourish us with singing and from the Word. And Father, we have many things to be happy for this morning. We have people who are recovering. Glenn's recovering and doing well, and we thank you for that. Brother Paul is here this morning. We thank you for that, Lord, and he's recovering day by day. We continue to pray for Maria, that she will be freed from this bondage of respiratory illnesses, and for Carl and his treatments and the medical attention that he will be needing. And Lord, we pray for your guidance in all of that. And Lord, bless your people this morning. We leave this all before you in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Now time for children's story. Children, collect your offering and come for your story from Mr. Willard.
Group we have today. Awesome. Thank you, Isabella. Wow, boy, how many of you guys are still in school? How much school is left? A week? 4 days or so? I was talking to one of you, 4 days left. Hot dog, when school's out, summer starts. Woohoo! Yeah. Well, boys and girls, I'm going to talk to you today about a little bit about what's proper. You know, Solomon says in Ecclesiastes 3, there's a time and a place for everything, like a time to build, a time to tear down, a time to plant, a time to harvest, a time to laugh, time to cry. So there's a time for everything, a proper time, right? So if you're in your car with your parents and the traffic light turns red, what happens? You stop, right? And then when the light turns green, the proper thing to do is go. Yeah. So even in school, if you're in the classroom, what's the proper thing to do? You sit still and listen, right? And then when you're on the playground, what's the thing to do? Woo-hoo! Run and play and holler. But y'all don't do that, do you? Boy, I did. Couldn't hold me back. Well, I got a story for you. I like to get out and walk in the morning. It's about what's proper, but I like to get out and walk in the morning. And I carry this with me. This is kind of an exercise ball, so I squeeze it like that. So I'm walking along, and I'm squeezing this ball, and I drop it. So it's rolling away from me downhill, and I thought, I can hear the crowd cheering, yay, Willard, yay, Mr. Willard. I'm in a soccer game all of a sudden. Do any of you play soccer? You guys play? Okay, y'all know what that's all about. So you put the ball down, you kick it, go around. So I'm doing that and everything. So I bring my foot around, and I'm going to kick the ball, and I'm going to make a goal. Here he goes, and the crowd's cheering, and everybody's on alert, and everybody's watching. And I tripped, and down I go. So for old people, is it improper to kick a ball? No, but is it improper not to pay attention to what you're doing? Huh? What do you think, guys? Should old people pay attention to what they're doing? I think so, yeah. That's a proper thing to do. That's where this came from. How many of you guys saw me last week? Yeah. Did it look worse last week? Yeah, it did. It was all black. Got my knee, too. But it was, not doing the right thing. But you know something, boys and girls, I have noticed sometimes we feel like we have our crayons out and we don't want to share. Have you ever done that? Or pencils, you don't want to share. Or at the playground, you don't want to take turns. We do. I want my turn first and all. But the Lord would have us to share. We're Christian boys and girls, right? Remember the Bible says, do unto others as you would have others to do to you, right? So if we're without crayons and someone would have crayons, would we want them to share? Yeah, of course we would. So boys and girls, if we follow the golden rule, then we'll always be doing the proper thing at the proper time. Okay, you can go back to your seats now.
Heavenly Father, bless us now. At the cross of Christ we bow. Take our guilt and grief away. Hear and heal us now. Now, O Lord, this very hour, send thy grace and show thy power, while we rest upon thy word, come and bless us now. Mercy now, O Lord, we plead, in this hour of utter need, turn us not away.
Son. Light and life are thou within. Savior thou from every sin. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
If you know the Lord, you need nobody else to see you through the darkest night. You can walk alone.
Take time
to pray.
was once a sinner, but I came hardened to receive from my Lord. This was freely given, and I found that he always kept his word. There's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine.
And it's mine.
Oh, yes, it's mine.
Yes, it's mine.
And the white robed angels sing the story. A sinner has come home.
Oh, come home.
Oh, there's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine.
And it's mine.
Oh, yes, it's mine.
Yes, it's mine.
With my sins forgiven, I am bound for heaven, nevermore to roam.
Well, good morning, friends. Let me hear you say, praise the Lord. That sounds wonderful.
In the book 'tis written, saved by grace, oh, the joy that came to my soul. Now I am forgiven, and I know by the blood I am made whole. There's a new name written out in glory, and it's mine.
And it's mine.
Oh, yes, it's mine.
Yes, it's mine.
And the white robe sing the story. A sinner has come,
oh,
home.
Has come home.
Oh, there's a new name written out in glory, and it's mine.
And it's mine.
Oh, yes, it's mine.
Yes, it's mine.
With my sins forgiven, I am bound for heaven.
So how do you praise the Lord at his house with the King's Heralds on Sabbath morning? You praise him any way you'd like. I'd like to give you a few suggestions you might like to try in your services. Raise your right hand. Go ahead. We're in America. Mm-hmm. Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Beautiful. Left hand. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Isn't that beautiful? Two hands. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Love that. Ooh, two hands. Hallelujah. Is that music? That's music to his ears, amen?
Praise the Lord, amen.
Now, some of you out there would like to sing along with the quartet. We invite you to do that. Please try and stay in the right key when you sing with us. Some of you would like to clap your hands, I can tell. But we know we teach our kids in Sabbath school, if you're happy and you know it, do what?
That's right.
Let's hear a good hand clap for our Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Yes,
amen.
Indeed.
Amen.
We're singing of his love, and we invite you all to join in and make the praise complete. I'd like to begin the introductions by introducing our newest member of our quartet, J.R. Rosa from the FBI. J.R. is our rookie of our quartet. He's been with us about 6 months. He's about done 25 concerts. He wears FBI glasses because he has problems with his eyes, and we'll tell you about that. But anyway, J.R. comes to us from a little town up in...
Careful now.
I got to say it just right.
You know what happened last time in Texas, right?
I know.
Just
he
careful.
He comes from
careful,
New
careful.
York City.
Oh.
But you what?
It happened again.
But what?
But I love Texas.
J.R. is... quite a fan of the King's Heralds, being raised around the King's Heralds, many of us have. And J.R. said, if I get the job, he says, I just want you to call me number 36. And I says, why 36? He says, I'm the 36th member of the King's Heralds Quartet. What number? So if you can't remember J.R., it's 36. J.R., I don't remember that from Dallas.
Even a flight attendant, literally, there was a empty seats in the plane, and she said, sir, would you like to sit in row 36? I'm like, if she knows I'm 36, You have to know I'm 36.
Give a warm welcome, won't you? J.R. Rosa.
Thank you. Happy Sabbath, everyone. How are you? No, I'm not from the FBI. No, far from the FBI. So I have a little cornea situation going on where my eye starts getting a little watery, a little red. So keep me in your prayers. I'm going through a little cornea procedure. So keep me in your prayers. So, but it's my privilege to introduce to you number 33, right here. This is our baritone, the baritone, that sophisticated vocal part that goes up and down and just keeps it all nice and tight. And my brother right here, Pastor John Watkins, is an expert at it from North Carolina, Pastor John Watkins.
Hey, good morning. So good to be with you folks down here in Texas. Everything is bigger in Texas, isn't it? Is it better too? I thought so. Well, you know, number 33 I thought was going to be the last one, but we're happy for number 36.
Absolutely.
And you know, I stand next to number 27. Mr. Jeff Pearls from Nashville, Tennessee, has been singing with the King's Heralds now for about 20 years. Let's give Jeff a warm welcome.
All right, thank you so much. Thank you so very much for that warm, wonderful welcome. It is so good to see all of you today. Your smiling faces, you have something to smile about, and I know what it is. When I stepped in here in the foyer, when we came in to set up this morning, I could already feel the presence of the Holy Spirit here.
Yes.
You have
yes.
something special here, folks. You need to guard it very, very carefully.
Yes.
You would be surprised the number of churches that you walk into. You can tell the culture of that church. You can tell the effectiveness of that church just in the first few minutes that you walk in. And I can tell that this is a very powerful and effective church in the Spirit of God. Amen?
Amen.
So you all are destined to do some great, great things. Well, it was my privilege now to introduce to you number two standing over here.
No, that would be...
This gentleman here is the senior member of our group. He has been hitting the high notes with the King's Heralds now for the past 40 years, all the way from South Bend, Indiana. Mr. Don Scroggs, make him welcome.
My heart is happy.
Thank you!
How many happy folks do we have here this morning? Raise your hands. All the happy folks. Here's a song for each and every one of you.
Once I was made sad by the heartbreak of sin, tears like a flood came storming within, when Jesus brought his sweet sunshine of amazing grace. A lifetime of tears his happiness replaced. My heart is happy,
oh so happy.
I'm satisfied, I've been redeemed,
I've been redeemed.
I'll give the world a smile.
Something within me, a newborn feeling inside.
My heart is happy,
oh so happy.
I'm satisfied.
I no longer see sin's depressing old song. No longer alone, for now to Christ I belong. And sadness must listen to me sing all the time. Well, you can get me down, and I will tell you why.
My heart is happy,
oh so happy.
I'm satisfied, I've been redeemed,
I've been redeemed.
I'll give the world a smile.
Something within me, a newborn feeling inside.
My heart is happy,
oh so happy.
I'm satisfied.
My heart is happy,
oh so happy.
I'm
so satisfied.
I
have been redeemed.
Give the world a smile.
My heart is happy, happy, I'm satisfied.
of sorrow, I leave it all behind. Every tear, every heartache, every mile I must roam, that much nearer heaven's glory and my eternal. Standing open, I see them standing open wide. Joy and glory waiting. Every sigh never shed. Tear in heaven, never grieve, never pine. When I leave this world of sorrow, I leave it all behind. Gates are standing open, I see them standing open wide. Tear in heaven, never grieve, never pine. When I leave this world of sorrow, I leave it all behind. I leave it all behind. I leave it all.
One of these days, friends, we're going to leave this old world of sorrow. Jesus Christ is coming in the clouds of heaven very, very soon to take all of his faithful children home. That's right. To a place that he's prepared just for them. And on that great day, the scripture will be fulfilled that says, old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Amen. And the question that we have for you this morning is, are you ready to meet him? Because it won't be very, very long. Amen. Well, I think that it would be appropriate at this time to feature number 36 on this next song. What do you think? Would that be all right with you? Well, about six of you want to hear him. I tell you what we're going to do. After we get done with this particular piece that features JR, if you like what you hear and you think we ought to keep him on in the group, we want you to let us know some way, somehow. Say amen, praise the Lord, clap your hand, whatever. Just communicate to us that you think that he's done well, you've liked what you've heard, and then he needs to stay on with the King's Heralds, okay?
You need to chill, man. This is Texas, man.
On the other hand, if you don't care for a thing in the world about what he's getting ready to do when he gets done, I want you just to sit there and look at him. Like a lot of you are looking at me right now, going, is this man serious? I can read your mind. No, I'm kidding. We love JR. He's a permanent member of the King's Heralds, but we want to feature him on a song that just simply says, take a little time to talk to the Lord.
Take a little time to talk to the Lord. Take a little time to talk.
Take a little time.
I take a little time to talk to the Lord. Take a little time to talk.
Oh,
I take a little time to talk.
With Jesus makes it
right. Take a little time to talk to the Lord.
A little time with Jesus makes it right.
Take a little time, all right. In troubles of every kind,
oh,
thank God I'll always find that a little talk with my Jesus makes it right, all right.
How well do I remember when I was a sinner, lost? I cried, have mercy, Jesus, but still my soul was tossed. I heard King Jesus say, come here I am the way. And a little talk with my Jesus makes it right. Oh, a little talk with the Jesus makes it right.
Take a little time to talk to the Lord.
A little talk with the Jesus makes it right.
Take a little time, all right. In troubles of every kind,
oh,
thank God I'll always find that a little talk with my Jesus makes it right, all right.
Sometimes the forked lightning and muttering thunder too, with trials and temptations, it's hard for me and you. But Jesus is our friend. He'll keep us to the end. And a little talk with my Jesus makes it right,
all right.
Oh, a little talk with the Jesus makes it right,
all right. Take a little time to talk to the Lord.
A little talk with the Jesus. Makes it
take a little time, all right. In troubles of every kind,
oh,
thank God I'll always find that a little talk with my Jesus makes it right, all right. Take a little time to talk to the Lord. Take a little time to pray. Take a little time to talk to the Lord. Take a little time to pray. Take a little time. Take a little time. Take a little time to pray. Take a little time. Take a little time. Take a little time to pray.
You heard that, didn't you? One more concert.
A good news,
chariot's coming.
Good news,
chariot's coming.
Good news,
chariot's coming. And I don't want to leave me behind.
A good news,
chariot's coming.
Good news,
chariot's coming.
Good news,
chariot's coming. And I don't want to leave me behind.
There's a long white robe in the heaven, I know.
There's a long white robe in the heaven, I know. There's a long white robe in the heaven, I know. And I don't want to leave me behind.
A good news,
chariot's coming.
Good news,
chariot's coming.
Good news,
chariot's coming. And I don't want to leave me behind.
For there's a golden crown in the heaven, I know.
There's a golden crown in the heaven, I know. There's a golden crown in the heaven, I know. And I don't want to leave me behind.
Good news,
chariots coming.
Sweet news,
chariots coming.
So glad,
chariots coming. And I don't want to leave me behind.
There's a starry crown in the heaven, I know.
There's a starry crown in the heaven, I know. There's a starry crown in the heaven, I know. And I don't want to leave me behind.
Good news,
chariots coming.
Sweet news,
chariots coming.
So glad,
chariots coming. And I don't want to leave me behind.
There's a golden harp in the heaven, I know.
There's a golden harp in the heaven, I know. There's a golden harp in the heaven, I know. And I don't want to leave me behind.
Good news,
chariots come.
Sweet news,
chariots come.
So glad,
chariots are coming. And I don't want to leave me behind.
A good news.
Chariots are coming.
Sweet news.
Sweet news.
chariots a-coming.
Good news.
Good news.
Good news.
Good news. And I don't want to leave. And I don't want to leave me behind. Yes, he included me. I'm so glad he included me when he shed his blood on Calvary. He looked ahead in time and he made all of heaven mine. Yes, my Lord included me.
In the beginning, God created a man in his image. It was a wonderful plan, but Adam listened to old Satan's advice. He took of the fruit and he didn't think twice, so Adam needed to be completely restored. And all this happened long before I was born. Jesus looked ahead and he saw my need, and he included me.
Yes, he included me. I'm so glad he included me when he shed his blood on Calvary. He looked ahead in time and he made all of heaven mine. Yes, my Lord included. So glad he included me when he shed his blood on Calvary. He looked ahead in time and he made all of heaven mine. Yes, my Lord included.
Things down now and do a song that was written by a preacher. Mm-hmm. Not just any preacher. This preacher's name was HMS Richards Sr. Many of you will recognize that name as one belonging to a very powerful minister of the gospel. But what folks may not realize about HMS Richards was that he was also a songwriter. He didn't write very many songs, but when he did, they were very poignant and powerful, and such is the case with this next song. Listen to one of his compositions, the very beautiful O Lord of Space.
O Lord of Space, of earth and sea and sky, thy word created all. Each blazing star and all the hosts of heaven.
marching high. Flame forth and whirl and awe. O Lord of space, the heaven of heavens above, thy sacred dwelling is. Eternal King thou art, and now more wondrous still the Lord of love.
Sticks closer than a brother. Yes. He's the friend that said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And he's the same friend that said, lo, I'm with you always, even to the end. Amen. And so if you came here this morning feeling like you don't have a friend in this world, can I tell you about a man named Jesus who loved you enough that he came from a glorious heaven to a dark earth, robed himself in flesh, and walked among us and showed us how to live. And then when the time came for him to empty himself and present himself a sacrifice, he allowed the very beings that he had created to mock him, spit upon him, pull his beard, beat him beyond recognition, And if that wasn't enough, then he allowed them to drag him to the outskirts of town, where they nailed him to an old rugged cross. And there he stood, and he hung suspended between heaven and earth in such indescribable agony that you and I will never have to go through, because he did it for us. Amen.
Amen.
And as the sun refused to shine and the father had to look away from the horrific scene, you could hear his voice echoing throughout the hills. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why would he do it, friends? He did it because he loves you and he loves me enough that he wanted to spend eternity with us. And that was the only way that heaven could be reconciled to earth. So I ask you this morning, are you thankful for Jesus?
Yes,
are you thankful for what he's done for you? Are you thankful that there's an empty tomb that says that he is not there? If you go to that tomb today, there's a sign in there that says he is not here, for he is risen.
Amen.
And I praise the Lord for that. Amen? Hallelujah.
Yes.
John Watkins, we hadn't planned to do this today, but I want you to play my favorite song for me. Would you do that? I know that if we had the time, we could go around this sanctuary today and we could count the miracles that God has done in each one of our lives. And it would just be awesome and amazing to hear what God is doing in each one of your lives. But John has a special song that I absolutely love to hear him play. It's my personal favorite. It's called I Believe in Miracles.
Can I sneak a real quick one?
If it's quick, I've never known a preacher to say anything quick.
Wow. It was just a few years ago that I was having a little pain in my area that I thought maybe would go away. Maybe it was my gallbladder, but it didn't go away. And to make a long story short, I found myself in an emergency room, which I'd never been before. And there was a gal there with tattoos all over her that looked like she was from the Wrestling Corporation. And she just came up to me and she says, Mr. Watkins, she says, you've had an event. I said, a what? She says, you've had an event. I said, what do you mean? She says, you've had a heart attack. I said, really? She said, we've got to check you in. You've got to see a doctor. And that put together a lot of circumstances. I met a young Marine doctor. He had six of those heart casts that day. I was number three. And with a man of very short words, and I'm not a man of a lot of short words, as these guys know. So I just, I waited my turn. And he told me, he says, now this is going to take about 40 minutes. And he told me what he would find, what he wouldn't find, and all of that stuff. And so I'd been praying all along. And all I could see, it was true enough, I was awake. It really didn't hurt that badly. And all I could see was the clock. And now it's an hour and 20 minutes. And I'm still there. So I said, how's it going? And the doctor said, well, he says, I'm having a little trouble. He said, you've got one blockage. It's totally blocked. He said, but I'm working on it. He said, we're not going to worry about it. If we can't get it, we'll solve it another way. Well, I didn't want to hear that. So I said to him, I know. I said, I'll say a little prayer for you. He proceeded to do what he did. And in the meantime, they took out one of the evidently, they put in a stent, but he never told me he got it. He never said anything to me, really, other than, we're going to keep you overnight, take this pill. And I woke up in the morning at CCU in the hallway, and he was clip-clopping down the hallway. I could hear him coming, and he, with all smiles, he had a black and white photo of all the stuff that was wrong. And I found out that I have an extra artery. Now, that's a God thing, I can tell you that right now. He said, only about 10% of the people even have one, and you have it, and that's where your blockage was. I said, well, then do I have any damage? He says, no, not any at all. And then he leans back on the wall as if he had all the time in the day, and he says, now I need to tell you something. He said, do you remember what you said to me yesterday? I said, yes, sir, I do. He said, what did you tell me? I said, I'm going to say a little prayer for you. He says, let me tell you something you don't know. He said, I had been spending about 45 minutes trying to get a needle through that clot, and at the moment that you said that, he said, the needle went right through the center of that clot. And he said something that I didn't hear, because by that time my eyes were flooded, but my wife heard it. He said, I felt some sort of a presence. Now, I didn't feel a thing. And he said, I went home last night and I shared this with my wife. And she made me come in here and tell you that this morning. My friends,
as Jeff has already said, we serve a God of miracles. And every one of us has our story, at least one. But I can assure you that our God is a miracle-working God. I'm going to play this song for you, and I'm going to invite you to sing on a chorus with me called I Believe in Miracles.
Because he lives, sing it, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all here is gone. Because I know he holds the future.
You're just getting warmed up. We have to do that again.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future, and life is worth living just because he lives.
You people can sing.
Yes,
amen. I wish we could just take you everywhere with us. If you don't have anything better to do tonight, come be with us in Richardson tonight and help us out over there. Would you do that? Would you do that? That was incredible. I'm curious about something here.
How many of you speak or understand Spanish? Let me see your... Oh, no. Normally, we try to do a song in Spanish, but we try to do it in places where we are quite confident that nobody speaks it. That way, if we don't do a good job, no one will know. But we came to the wrong place here this morning, fellas. So here's the deal. I guess we've kind of committed ourselves here to try this. And so... We don't speak Spanish. I'm just going to tell you. JR speaks fluent Spanish, but the rest of us, we have a hard enough time with English, okay? You can tell by the way I talk, I'm not bilingual, all right? So we're going to ask you to do us a favor. If we do good, then that's great. You can tell us we did good. And if we did do bad, please tell us we did good anyway, all right?
Tell us in Spanish, we won't understand.
That's right. Yeah, just tell us in Spanish, we won't know the difference. So feel free to sing along with this beautiful song. I'm sure you all know it, Más Allá del Sol.
Aunque en esta vida no tengo riquezas, sé que allá hay.
Song shall ever be
praise the Lamb who died for me, and I'll sing it while ages shall roll.
When a million years have passed in that wonderful place, our song of praise will just have begun.
And my song will never end while I look on his face. And my song will never be done. And while the ages roll, I'll keep on praising him. And my voice will never tire or grow. And my song shall ever be, praise the Lamb who died for me, and I'll sing it while ages shall roar. I'll sing it while
Scripture tells us that when we get to heaven, there's going to be a song that only the redeemed will be able to sing. We don't know the lyric to that song this side of heaven, but maybe when we get there and begin to sing it, it will go a little something like this. And my song shall ever be, praise the Lamb who died for me. And we will sing that song around our Father's throne through all eternity, in a land of love, joy, peace, harmony, tranquility. I don't know about you, friends, but that sounds like a place I'd like to live. Sounds like home, doesn't it? But until that great day when we can call heaven our home and it becomes a reality, we have some living down here to do. Before Jesus left his disciples at the conclusion of his earthly ministry, he told them, he said, when you get the gospel of this kingdom preached to all the world, then I will come back and take you home. That was 2,000 years ago. And we're still here. That must mean that there's still some work left for us to do. Amen. We believe in going into all the world, do we not? We believe in the Great Commission, do we not? So today, we're going to give all of you a chance to partner with this ministry so that together we can get the job done that Christ gave us to do so that we can go home. How many of you believe that Jesus' coming is not far off? I believe that we're living in the last days of the last days. If there's any doubt in your mind as to whether or not Jesus is coming soon, go home after church and read Matthew, the 24th chapter. And then if you're still not convinced tonight, if you have nothing better to do, turn on your favorite version of the news and watch about as much of it as you can stand. And you will see that your Bible could be a script for the evening news. You see, Jesus told his disciples some of the signs that would signal the end of the age. He said, when you see wars and rumors of wars and pestilence and famines and earthquakes, he said, that's just the beginning of sorrow. So a lot of times as Christians, we don't like to think about this, but if that's just the beginning, then we better fasten our seatbelts because we're in for a bumpy ride in until we land safely on the other side. Amen. But Jesus promised that he would go before us, and he would protect us. So that's where we have to put our faith, is in Jesus Christ. This morning, we're going to give you an opportunity to partner with this ministry. The first and most important way that you can partner with us is through your prayers. We covet your prayers. We have learned that anytime you get off the sidelines and get on the playing field to do anything for the Lord, we have an enemy who seeks to kill, steal, and destroy, and he will stop at nothing to hinder the work of God and to throw up obstacles in your way. So we would just ask that you would keep the King's Heralds in your prayers. The second way that you can support this ministry is this evening. If you've been blessed, go to our website and order some of our music. I promise it'll be a blessing to your home. The third way that you can support this ministry is through the use of this blue envelope that you should have received in your bulletin. If you received your blue envelope, would you just wave it at me? Where are my blues? Where are my blues? There they come. All right, all right. If you'll be so kind as to take that blue envelope and open it up. I'd like to call your attention very quickly to the very first line item that just simply says, yes, I want to join the King's Herald's Faith family to keep this unique ministry alive. My friends, the King's Herald's Faith family is a very precious, unique, and important group of people without which this ministry would have gone by the wayside 2 years ago. These are the folks that support this ministry on a systematic monthly basis. We're only asking for $25 a month. When you add that up, that's $300 for the year. When you break that down, that's 84 cents a day, less than the price of a bottle of water. I can't tell you the number of times during the past year or two that Don would call us when we were locked down, couldn't minister anywhere, couldn't go anywhere, couldn't do anything, couldn't see anybody, couldn't record anything. We were just there. And he would call us and he would say, fellas, we've got just enough meal in the barrel, so to speak, for one more payroll, and then we'll just have to see what God does. And can I tell you that every single time the phone would ring in our office, sometimes several times, and there would be a precious person on the other end of the line, just like you folks here, saying, you know, God has just laid your ministry on our hearts. We just want you to know we're going to send you a little something because we know that you haven't been able to be out there on the road ministering. Just keep your eyes open for it. That happened time after time after time. And can I tell you, this morning, all the bills are paid. We have decent clothes to wear. We have a warm place to sleep. We have reliable transportation. You can take one look at each and every one of us on this platform and see we haven't been missing any meals. And so God is good. This morning, we'd ask you to prayerfully consider joining our faith family if you've not already done so. We realize that some of you here may not be able to do that. We want you to know that one-time love gift is very much appreciated. On the other hand, there may be those of you here that can do well and above the 300. We're going to leave that between you and the Lord today. We would just ask that you would be obedient to whatever God would lay on your heart to give. And as our way of saying thank you to you, we will send you a receipt that will be of some benefit to you. We will collect this love offering at the end of the service. We'll have a couple of deacons at the back doors with offering plates. So you can just slip your love gift in this blue envelope. If you're going to make out a check, just make it out to King's Herald's. And we'll thank you in advance for whatever God lays on your heart to give. I know that in a congregation this size, there are those of you here this morning that are going through storms. When you came in here this morning, you were no doubt greeted. And the conversation may have gone a little something like this. Happy Sabbath, how are you? I'm doing great, how are you? And you know what? I would dare say that most of you told the truth. But some of you maybe stretched the truth a little bit because in your world, you're anything but fine. Maybe last night when you went to bed, everything was good. But this morning you got that phone call. You got that piece of news that has just shaken you to your very core. And everything that can be shaken, has been shaken, including your faith in the Lord. And you're here this morning going, God, why am I having to be in the middle of a storm? I didn't ask to be here. I'm so confused. All I can hear is the wind howling about. I can feel the rain pounding in on me, and all I can see is storm clouds everywhere I look. Lord, why? My friend, we don't have all the answers this side of heaven. Jesus Christ promised us. He said, in this world you will have trouble, and he was very definite about that point. But I'm glad he didn't stop there. He said, but be of good cheer, for I have what? Overcome the world. And so if you're a child of God this morning, Jesus is your Savior, you're an overcomer. No matter what you're going through, no matter how hopeless the situation may seem. But let me tell you, Jesus is bigger than any problem that any of us in this room
That's right.
would ever have.
Amen.
And so this morning, if that's you and you're struggling in your relationship with Jesus Christ, just reach up. Just say, Lord, I don't understand it all, but help me. I believe, Lord, but help my unbelief. I'm trying my best, and I'm reaching up as in the only way that I know how. Lord, would you just put your hand in my hand? And I'm going to cling to you because that's the only thing I can do right now. And then as you lead me, I'm going to put one foot in front of the other. And if we're totally honest, there are some days when we have just enough strength to do just that. And that's all we can do. But Christ only asks us to trust him. If you'll do those things, my friend, pray that simple prayer, put your hand in his hand and put one foot in front of the other. He promised he'd get you safely home. He promised that he would lead you through the storm. He'll be with you. He'll walk with you, and he'll minister to you in the midst of your storm and stay with you until your storm passes by.
Of the midnight, have I oft hid my face, while the storm howls above me, and there's no hiding place. In the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry. Safe till the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky, from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand. Keep me safe till the storm passes by.
When the long night has ended and the storms come no more, let me stand in thy presence on that bright, peaceful shore.
In that land where the tempest never comes, Lord, may I dwell with thee. When the storm passes by, till the storm passes over,
thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky, from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand. Keep me safe.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We have so much to be thankful for. Let's sing Thank You, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now let's sing He is Coming like we mean it.
He is coming. He is coming. He is coming. He is coming.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Have you been blessed today?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You know, I couldn't help but think, gentlemen, as you were singing, what is it going to be like in the earth made new? When all our voices will blend together, praise our Creator. And it won't be a concert that will come to an end in 30 or 45 minutes. It'll just go on and on and on. It's just hard to fathom what it will be like to be in the presence of Jesus, to express our praise, our gratitude, and our honor to Him for what He has accomplished and done for us, making it possible for us to be there. Thank you so much for being with us. We greatly appreciate this. Don, when you invited everyone to sing, you just made one request that everybody stay on tune. Mickey said you were looking right at me when you said that. You know, we deeply appreciate this. I know that in all your repertoire of music, you have one more song you could sing. And it won't make you late for Richardson this evening. So, could you do that for us? I don't think anybody's looking at their clock or watch or timepiece, but we would thoroughly enjoy, even if it's one you did before. We would love to hear it again. Thank you so much. And then we'll have the benediction.
long I had panted for a drink from some clear spring that I hoped would quench the burning of the thirst I felt within. Hallelujah, I have found him whom my soul so long has craved. Jesus satisfies my longings. Through his blood I now am saved.
Feeding on the husks around me till my strength was almost gone, longed my soul for something better, only still to hunger.
Well of water ever springing, bread of life so rich and free, untold wealth that never faileth, my Redeemer is to me. Hallelujah, I have found him whom my soul so long has craved. Satisfies my longings. Through his blood I now am saved. I am saved. Hallelujah, I have found him whom my soul so long has craved. Jesus satisfies my longings. Through his blood I now am saved. Jesus satisfies my longings.
Stand with me as we go to the Lord in prayer. Loving Father in heaven, all praise and alleluia belong to you. Thank you for these moments that we could praise you and worship you. Thank you, Father, for the gift of music, the ministry of music that has been shared with us by the King's Heralds. We pray your special blessing upon them, their ministry, their service for you, as they give encouragement and uplift and praise. Looking forward to that wonderful day when we can be gathered together in your eternal kingdom. Now, Father, the Lord bless us and keep us. May you make your face shine upon us and be gracious to us. Lord, lift up your countenance upon us and give us of your peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.